men this evening with us. I appreciate this very much because it's difficult to get to know your candidates in such a short period, and it's such an important decision because your candidates here will be with you for the next 4 years, so they are important decisions. I'll just say that investment in the NWT is critical. We need experience in the Assembly with people who can build partnerships, work with others, understand Aboriginal governments, and be willing to work with them, willing to hear their issues. Some people who work with federal government, and that's the time this evening. So thank you.
Thank you. Throw the language check.
Great. Well, I wanted to thank Joss and the organizers as well, and everyone here who was very patient listening to a lot of the questions. Being a candidate is probably one of the most incredible experiences that I've ever gone through. It's been very humbling, especially with the questions going door to door. And I think it taught me a lot about myself as an owner, as a resident, and as a father. So I want to thank my candidates here. They were great on the trail. They had some laughs and some fun. And that's basically what it should be. It should be about fun and helping our community. Thank you very much, and we'll see you on the 3rd.
And Dave Wasseltzer, Grange Lake.
Just want to say thank you for everybody for coming out, and thanks to the organizers for putting this together. One of the things that strikes me tonight after hearing everyone's comments is that so many things, whether they're digital connectivity or housing or crime or anything, the solution isn't always just legislation and regulation. We focus a lot on that, on strategies, but what we don't focus on is having responsible government, having vision, having some leadership. There's a lot of things we need to do to engage the federal government and engage the citizens and residents of the Northwest Territories, and the 7th Assembly needs to do that to move us forward. So I hope everyone gets 7 votes on Monday. Thank you.
Norm Smith, Grange Lake.
Well, thank you very much. I enjoyed it tonight. Learned a little bit, and it was great. Yellowknife has been my home for 33 years. My wife, children, and grandchild were all born and raised here. My work experience, strong union background, has provided me with skills to provide sound representation for the constituents of Grange Lake. I've advocated for people for many years, the last 5 years professionally. I will be a strong voice with proven skills advocating for your issues.
So on October 3rd? Can I finish that? October 3rd, vote for experience, leadership, and proven advocacy.
Thank you. Thank you everybody for coming out. Been here for 32 years, been through the trenches and the good times and the bad times. We're hearing negative things, the mines closing down. The mines was built this territories. We can do it again. We have to work together. The federal government has to come with a blueprint to assist us on that. There's many positive things coming in the future. Swiss Air is coming in. There's an airline looking. It was here in the 80s that promised for 700 jobs. We just couldn't have enough people, but they're coming back again looking. There's the
McKenzie pipeline.
Thank you. Bernard LeBlanc.
Thank you. I've done some research over the last few years on geothermal systems. My friend David Malcolm, who is an engineer and a former director of Arctic Energy Alliance, and also a Norton engineering firm, said it looks good. Do we have a couple of millions to really explore the potential of this resource? Just yesterday I was reading an article put out by a Canadian Geological Survey Agency that the North has the best potential to benefit from geothermal energy.
But sorry, 30 seconds comes really quickly. When you use the frame way.
Thank you. I also would like to thank the organizations that sponsored the forum tonight. Thank you, Jocelyn, for doing a great job. Thank you to everybody who came. We had some good discussions, absolutely. I would just like to say that I've proven that I can do a good job. I would like to go back and do the same good job again for another term. I want to encourage everybody to get out and vote. I think this is probably a very committed group of voters, but please take a friend with you who doesn't normally vote. And on October 3rd, I would be pleased if you would vote B0. Thank you.
Thank you. Doug Spence, Friendly.
I would like to thank you, Jocelyn, and the organizers of this forum tonight. I would like to thank all of you for participating and contributing in a positive way to the democratic process. I'm a man of action. My track record has proven that. I understand the reality and concerns of the family of Frame Lake. On October third vote Duff Spence to build, so we can build together a positive future for Crane Lake.
And for Grace Lately, Glenn Aboriginal.
Thank you, and I'd like to thank you all for coming and joining us this evening. It's been great to have you here and to ask the questions, and it's been an honor to answer your questions. I'd like to thank my parents as well. And we're up here because of all the people that have helped us, and I have a significant number of volunteers and supporters who have been very helpful over the last couple of weeks. So I want to thank them, but in particular my parents who have been there throughout this whole thing, and 4 years ago they were here through that whole thing. So thanks, Mom and Dad. And I'd like to just close with, I'd like to continue
working.
Hey, you gave him more time. I saw you do it.
Thanks, Scott.
Key words: balance, partnerships, collaboration, vision. We need all of those to move forward. I ran because I was frustrated at wheels being spun over and over again over the last 4 years. I have experience in government, in Aboriginal groups, and in nonprofit organizations doing community development. I want to bleed the Great Slave Riding into the next 4 years and get the job done. Thank you.
Thank you. Bob Bromley, Monday.
Thanks to all the organizers and all of you for coming out. I see many repeat offenders, devils for punishment here. I will continue to make the connections between the economic, social, and environmental aspects of every decision we take. And thanks to my wife, Marianne, for all her help. Whatever job I'm in, I'll be having the same perspective. Awesome.
Mark Bogan, Wellington.
In October, my wishes are to take oaths to serve people like you. Two prominent oaths to a person like me are to promote equality for all of our people, to promote legislation, policies, and services for the good of the people as individuals, families, and communities. This is my wish for you. This is your voice, and I hope that you will support my mark. Thank you.
Thank you. Dave Ramsey, Cam Lake.
Thank you very much, Jocelyn, and I'd like to thank the organizers as well. As well, I'd like to thank the audience for your questions this evening. I think some very important issues facing the Northwest Territories, you brought to light a number of those. I have been an MLA for 8 years. I've got the experience. I hope to continue on in that role after October 3rd. And if anybody hasn't had the ability to ask a question, I'll make myself available after to answer any questions people have as well. So please see me after if you have a question, you didn't get to the mic. Thank you.
And finally, Brian Sutherland of Cameron.
Thank you, everybody. I'd just like to say I still have an issue coming out of here. I do believe there's a fiscal problem coming down the pipe, and I don't feel like the Legislative Assembly gets it. They don't get it, they can't do anything to prevent it. They're not going to take building mines seriously. They're not going to take deregulating seriously. So as you come out of this election, do you really think that the Legislative Assembly understands that they're running out of money? And if not, what are they going to do about it? Thank you.
All right, and that brings us to the next evening. Thanks. And thanks so much to all the candidates for coming out. Make sure you get out and vote on October 3rd. And a little plug for CBC, of course, we will be broadcasting live on October 3rd, starting at 8 o'clock, right after the polls close. Thanks.